Good morning, everybody. This is Regan Adams with All Things Regan. Thank you so much for joining me this morning. So real quick, because my daughter is sitting in the front room with an attitude because I told her I had to do a live really quick. I wanted to talk about a conversation that I had this morning, which if you know me, you know I love really good conversation. It's just like my thing. And I was talking to one of my homegirls about some other stuff that we need to do as far as like an event this week. And so we kind of were also got into the mode of like dating. So talking about dating stuff, which is again my lane. And if you haven't gone and joined my group, Dating is Dead, Who Killed It, please go ahead and do so. Excuse me. It is for married people, single people, people in situationships, divorce, widow. It's for everybody because we're genuinely learning about relationships. And I have therapists in the group, and actually not this week coming, but the week after that, I'm going to have a guest relationship therapist on to talk about dating. So let me just go ahead and start there. I asked a question yesterday to the men in my group, who taught you how to date? And a lot of the men basically said they learned from like TV or somebody, some people told them, but maybe it wasn't the best advice. So essentially, you know, they don't know. And I find even at the age of 42 that we still don't know. Sorry, I need to drink some hot water or something. But anyway, and so it also put me in the mind of like expectations. And I know for me, I have to kind of be very mindful of my expectation of people. And I actually posted about this past week because I just expect a lot out of people because I kind of set the bar kind of high when I deal with people like in business or dating, just period. But we have to know that everybody is not the same person. We all treat each other differently. We were raised differently. We're used to different things. Especially as you get older, you're used to kind of settling into a certain situation. Like, you don't want to change and do things. And what I do know is I never want to get into a relationship seeking to change the person. I actually did that with my ex-husband, or tried to, and it was just a lot of effort. And so with that, going into dating, you don't want to go in thinking you're going to change a situation. Now, there are some things you're going to have to compromise on. But for the most part, we need to just make sure that we're finding a common ground and operating in that common ground and making sure that we can live with those things that, you know, make it on our nerves. But the main conversation that I was talking about with my friend was that making sure that we keep our standards. And everybody's standards are different. I know for me, I have a standard, but I'm trying to like figure out how to maneuver that when dating. So there's some things, like especially with me being married prior to dating, that I'm just not, like, there's a lot of qualities like I'm just not going to deal with. But some stuff I know that I need to kind of scale back and be like, Regan, that's not really realistic. So that's where my friends come in at. Also, one thing that has really helped me with dating is I'm not desperate. And I wish that for every woman. So that's basically what this conversation is about, that you don't date desperate. The way you don't date desperate is to have a full life. I've done a video on this before, but I felt like I needed to reiterate that. For me, when I say I don't date desperate, who doesn't like to go out on dates? Who doesn't like to spend time with the person that they like? And side note, I don't like dating multiple people. So once I find like the one person that I'm kind of keen in on, I'm on them. So who doesn't like, you know, spending time with that person? But if that does not work out, you know, and you find that, you know, this, you know, not forcing the relationship or not forcing whatever it is, if you find that that doesn't work, you should be cool with like walking away from it. And the way you can be cool with walking away from it is also making sure that you're always working in your purpose. So when I say I don't date desperate, I don't date desperate because I have a very full life on my own and I'm busy on my own. And not saying, because some men will look at me, and I've actually heard this before with prior dates, that, you know, you don't have room for me. You are always busy with your business. You're always busy with, and I am, that is a part of me. However, we make time for what we want to make time for. And so there's always room for a special somebody in my life if they want to have that. If I don't feel like they're making room for me, I'm not going to make a special effort for them. So I'm never going to just show my whole self when I'm dating a lot of the time. You'll just see pieces of me. And in the midst of that, I'm always going to make sure that I'm working. I work every day. Like, I work my job, but I work my business. That's 24/7. It never stops. Because that's something that I enjoy. I can do that and not get paid for it. And so the conversation this morning, it was basically like, I'm going to always make sure that I'm walking in God's purpose for my life. Always, 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 always. And what is going to happen is, while I'm doing that, the right person is going to come along for me. And I'm not going to have to force any relationships. And that's what my homegirl was telling me today. She was like, you know, when I meet somebody, how will I know? And I just said, you're just going to know. Like, I feel like when I do it, you're just going to know. You're not going to have to really like try to take stuff apart and trying to figure it out. I just don't think you will. Now, is it going to come like easy? No, because especially at this age, you know, you deal with past hurts, not only your past hurts, but this other person's, you know, past hurts and, you know, traumas. And maybe you're not the same girl that they're used to dealing with, or, you know, they're used to women doing certain things and maybe you don't do that. So you're learning this person and they're learning you. And it's like, I don't like that, or it's okay. But you just got to find a common ground, right? But in the midst of that, making sure that you both are walking in God's purpose for your life. And so that's like my biggest thing, and why I'm, to me, successful. Excuse me, I'm so sorry. Let me get some water. While I'm somewhat successful in dating, because I'm not out looking for a man. I'm never out looking for a man, like, but I put myself in position to be found. And that's what my dating coach told me a long time ago. Like, if you want to date, make sure that when you're out, you know, you look nice, as I do today, even though my hair needs to be done, and that's okay, but I'm still cute with my turban, you know, just making sure that you're putting yourself out there. Even though I'm taking my daughter and her friends out, I'm still out. So making yourself available, being out in the public eye to be put in positions to be chosen. I'm not hard up for a man. Don't think I ever will be, to be honest. And I know somebody made the comment when I said something about it, because I have been divorced it'll be a month next year, a month in November, I'm sorry. But I was single because he was gone for over 4 years. But I just wasn't like actively dating. So I know what it feels to be alone and be single, but not necessarily dating. So I just started dating. But I think sometimes we make it more difficult than what it should be. And, you know, some women are like, well, you know, you haven't been out here. But here's the thing, because I'm so engulfed in building my legacy, for my household and my business and helping people. I have my church. Like, I have a really, really full life on my own. Yes, I have room for somebody who wants to come in and join that, if that's, you know, and support that, and I support them. But I'm not like hard up for it. And right now I'm just in a spot where I'm really enjoying my life. And whoever I get will be able to add to that. It's just kind of like the cherry on top. So some people are like, I need a man. I need to be married. I need to be in a relationship. And yeah, I understand. Like, I'm not saying like it ain't some nights, or, you know, sometimes you be like, dang, I want to have some time to spend. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying I'm superwoman. Like, I understand what you're saying. But for the most part, like, my life is full. And when you're so busy with getting that together, like, you needing a man, nobody needs a man, nobody needs a woman, but you do want to have that companionship, so I got it. But in the midst of you doing that, please make sure that you're working on building yourself and being a better person and learning more about yourself so you can be a better mate to whoever that you're going to be connected to. And that's what I strive for every day, especially in my Dating is Dead group, because I'm forever learning. Like, I have a friend of mine, he calls me the dating guru, and I'm like, I'm not a dating guru. Like, I don't know about dating. I'm learning about dating. I love dating. I love marriage. I love love. I'm intrigued with it. So I love having conversations about it. But I'm in love with the fact that we can have these conversations, like grown-up conversations, along with therapists who are going to be able to, you know, mediate what we're talking about, so we can really get down to the bare bones of what love is, why we can't love, why we, you know, and look at it from different points of view. That's what I'm in love with. So guru, absolutely, I am not. But I do enjoy what I do. I do love seeing love, specifically black love, in marriages, in relationships, and people finding a relationship that they want. And I wholeheartedly believe that the next relationship that I get, like, it's going to be, like, so bomb. Like, I just... Perfect? No. But I believe it's just going to be bomb, and I'm going to be an asset, or we're going to be an asset to the kingdom of God, and then also our community as well. So I'm excited about that. And I know, you know, I had a guy tell me one time I'm very high maintenance. And it may appear to be so. And I do have standards. However, I'm fair. And I listen. I'm hard-headed, and I'm selfish, and I'm stubborn sometimes, but I listen. And I like to, you know, even though I may not come out and just say, hey, you're right, or whatever, I still ponder on what you say. And so I have to do that, especially being in business and being in the forefront of a dating business or a relationship group in a business. So, and even, excuse me, with my women's group, I have to do the same, right? So anyway, I'm not going to hold you guys. I just wanted to pop on here and just shed a little light on the dating thing. Like, concentrate on looking your best, being your best self, your highest self. Like, that's my everyday thing. Go out and find another. Like, I'm really into lipsticks now. So I have been, like, finding different colors that look good on my skin tone, making sure I'm taking care of my skin, self-care. Like, I was supposed to have a hair appointment this past week, but got to reschedule that. Making sure I'm, you know, trying to take care of my body, trying to go to the gym. I missed this past week. Eating better. Just having a healthy lifestyle from the inside out. Not necessarily you always eating good and stuff like that, because I had somebody tell me, how you going to promote holistic and you be eating all this stuff? Listen to me. It's not always food. Like, yes, food is a part of it, but holistic as in your mind, what you put in your mind, who you're attached to, and your body, your spirit, because what's inside does come out. Like, how you feel about yourself comes out, right? And that's what I want to promote. I am the holistic life shifter named by Shamika Dean. Because when you come into contact with me, like, seriously come into contact with me, you have no reason but to move. Like, you can't stay stagnant in the situation that you're in, because I'm an encourager. I love to see people do well. And so for me to be able to speak into the lives of others, you have to see that I'm living a certain way. And I don't want to fake it. Like, that's my thing. Like, I don't want to be one of those coaches or those people that are faking. Yes, I have insecurities like everybody else. Yes, I have problems like everybody else. But what do? I come on here and I talk about them. Because the more real I am to you, the more that you feel comfortable talking to me. And I'm always going to try to make sure that I'm working out my problems in front of you. And that's what God told me to do a long time ago. And that's still what I'm doing. So anyway, you guys have a blessed day. I'm getting ready to go out here and hang out with my daughter and her lovely friends. And I'm late and they all mad, just sitting there waiting on me. But guess what? There's nothing they can do about it, because I'm driving. And it's my time. You guys have a blessed day. This is Regan Adams with All Things Regan. And Regan says, I think it, I see it, I do it.